Hello and a very warm welcome to Saurav Sir's classes. Today's tutorial will be on LSAT. We will scrutinize the section 1 of this particular paper in brief, okay? So, without wasting any further time, let's get started with the tutorial. So this is the section 1, as I have already mentioned. The time allotted for this particular section is 35 minutes and you need to answer 25 questions in total. Now, what is given here is a paragraph, okay? And based on this particular paragraph, they will ask you one question. They have been provided 4-5 options in total and you need to pick the most that particular option that actually supports the argument. Okay, so let us read the paragraph first. So the paragraph says, of all the surgeons that are practicing at the city hospital, okay, what has happened? The chief surgeon has a worst record, and this is in terms of percentage of the patient who die, that is during or immediately following an operation performed by him. So it is a case of a hospital, and in particular we are talking about the chief surgeon. His performance is poor because the number of patients that die during or immediately after the operation is actually increasing. Okay? Paradoxically, the hospital's administrators claim that he is the best surgeon currently working at the hospital. So he has been titled as best surgeon by the administrators. So it is actually a contradiction. Once you are giving him the title of best surgeon, however, the situation says that he is not good because the percentage of people are increasing, you are actually dying. Okay, so the questions involve, or it actually further adds, which one of the following is true? Go furthest towards showing that the administrator's claim and the statistics cited might both be correct. Okay, that means this is also correct for the time being and this is also correct. So let's do it. So we'll first look at option number A. Option number A says, since hospital administrators appoint the chief surgeon, the administrators are strongly motivated to depict the chief surgeon they have chosen as a wise choice. So in this particular state option, what we see is that this is a perhaps second best answer that I can put forward with regard to this particular paragraph. The implication of the stated conflict of interest is that administrators may or might exaggerate the abilities of the chief surgeon. It may happen, okay? It may be the case. However, this is a maybe case, so it's just a speculation, okay? So if there is no conflict of interest, it would still be possible that the staff would consider him the best surgeon. So, A can be the second best answer for us, but it is not the first choice. So, this explanation we are rejecting and saying no to it. Let us move on to option number B. B says, in appointing the current chief surgeon, the hospital as administrators followed the practice well established at City Hospital of promoting one of the surgeons already on staff. However, how he was appointed actually does not resolve the discrepancy that lies between the chief surgeon's reputation versus his poor record. So it does not give us any information as to why these two things are happening simultaneously. So again, we have to reject B. Let us move on to C. C says, some of the younger surgeons on the city hospital staff received part of the training from their current chief surgeon. Okay? So, in this particular option, this actually does not resolve the discrepancy between the reputation and the poor record, though it does seem imply that younger surgeon that are actually trained under him might be loyal to him. Can be the case, okay? However, this would actually have relevance only if these surgeons, not the hospital administrators, claimed the chief surgeon was the hospital best surgeon. But this is not the case. It is the administrators who are claiming this. So definitely C is also out of sight. Let us now move on to option number D. D says at city hospital those operation, let me reduce the ink size further, that inherently entail great risk to life of the patient are generally performed by chief surgeon. Now this actually kind of, or I'll say it fully explains the paradox really very well. That means if the chief surgeon is assigned high risk cases, it's to be expected that they would have a higher number of patients to die because it involves a high amount of risk. Patients to die. So, for example, suppose 90% of surgery patient at the hospital survive their operation, but only 75% of the chief surgeon patients survive. Same, this is a case, okay? So clearly the chief surgeon's survival rate is much lower than the average rate of the hospital, definitely. But if the chief surgeon is only performing open heart surgery, say, which is very, very difficult, involves a lot of risk, then the national survival rate of these operations is just 50%. And compared to this 50%, this 75% is much higher. And it is actually very impressive, I'll say. So D has a high chance that it will be the explanation towards the paradox. However, before saying that D is actually our answer, we have to look at E even. E says that the current chief surgeon has a best record of patients surviving surgery than his immediate predecessors. So this statement is a passage that compare the chief surgeon current performance to the current staff and not to that of the previous staff or previous chief surgeon, which would have been a little helpful, but that this is not the case. Whatever it is, so we will also escape E or take it out of sight. So the correct answer to this particular question that actually explained the paradox of administrators giving him the title of best surgeon as well as his poor record can be actually explained well with option number D. So D will be the correct answer that must be picked with respect to question A. So I hope this short tutorial on LSAT, where we are discussing section 1 of the paper and how to solve it was helpful. In case there is any doubt, you are free to call or WhatsApp us on this particular number. And thank you so much for watching.